Hello, everyone. Welcome. Hey, we appreciate you watching this video. As you can see, I'm here with Dr. Ike Reichard. And coming up February 28th, okay, March 1st, March 2nd, down in Cancun, Mexico, is our Titanium and Your Home Sold Guaranteed Realty Quantum Leap Conference. Okay, this event, if you've been to any of our conferences before and you had comments like this, oh my goodness, this was the best event I've ever been to. I'm so glad I came. Well, when you show up to this three-day conference down in Cancun, you will absolutely say that. You're not just going to say, oh my goodness, this was the best conference that I've ever been to. I want you to 10X whatever your previous experiences were with other events. This will be a transformative 3 days for you and your business, personally, professionally, and financially. And I'm guaranteeing it, as you've heard me say. So Dr. Ike Reichard is going to be joining us down there in Mexico. He's going to be doing several sessions with us today. He's bringing his best angles, experiences, and material to be able to help us out. So Ike, first of all, my man, thank you so much for taking us up on the invitation to come down and speak with us. We appreciate that.
Well, it was a hard choice to make, Todd. Cancun in February, the 1st of March, or in Atlanta with cold and wet. I'm looking forward to going there and thawing out with everybody and getting started on a brand new year, Todd. And one of the things that I'm excited about talking to you guys about is, Todd, you know that I have a tremendous friendship with John Maxwell. He's been my friend now for probably 30 plus years. And Zig Ziglar introduced the two of us. And so because of that relationship, John just kind of communicates sometimes with a couple of his friends. And the other day he sent to me as the end of the year was coming. He said, you know, the last week of each year, I asked myself these questions. And he says, there are four questions that I ask that are looking back questions. And then there's one for the right now. And then there's four that are looking forward. And so he said, these are the kinds of questions. And these are the things I want to work with the group on while I'm there taking John's questions. And he said, question number one is, what made me proud? When I look back over this past year, what is it that you would say made you really proud about what you've accomplished? Number two question, what did I learn? Was there something, some great learning that I really came into? You know, ironically for me, Todd, it's around generosity. And you've been teaching me so much about that with your attitude that you have about giving, and that the size of the hole that you give through is going to be equal to the size of the hole that you're going to be receiving through. And so you've taught me a lot there. But the biggest thing I learned this year, Todd, is that we are going to finish our campaign that you helped us on at Must Ministries. We're going to go over our goal of what we needed in order to be able to do this campaign. And Todd, we're talking about altogether a $23 million campaign that was going on during the pandemic. While a lot of people pumped the brakes and said, let's sit back, one of my greatest learnings last year and the last 2 years really is that during a crisis is the time when you can absolutely shine the most. So what made me proud? What did I learn? Who did I lead? Was there someone that I really invested in? Because you and I know at some point, no matter how good you are, no matter how much energy you have, you're going to max out. And then the people that you've surrounded yourself with are going to help to determine your level of success. And I still subscribe to that old theory. Show me your five best friends that really influence your life, and I'll show you what your future is going to look like. So who did you lead? And then a huge question, what held me back? And then the question for now was one that really made me ponder over this last week since John sent this to me. Do I still love what I do? Do I still love what I do? And as long as you're in love with what you're doing, it makes all the difference in the world. And then the go forward questions that we'll talk about, am I willing to pay the price again this year? You know, Babe Ruth once said, yesterday's home runs don't win today's game. I mean, it's nice to look back and go, wow. But hey, are you willing to pay the price again this year? What's most important right now is another question. What do I need to change? And what is my word for the year? What is it that you want to be able to do? You know, the Georgia Bulldogs chose the word, and the word was elite. And Kirby Smart said, you're either elite or you're not. And that's been kind of their word for the year, and resilience. Choose a word. What's going to be your word for this next year, or your phrase? For me, it's going to be best ever. It's just going to be my best ever year. And I listen. Well, I know if I'm in a car, I got a lot more miles in the rearview mirror than I do in the windshield. So I'm trying to make every moment count and to make sure I'm living my very best. I don't want to, you know, be living in the twilight. I want to be creating some highlights. So, Todd, that's what I'm fired up about talking to that group about in Cancun and sitting by the pool. And man, I'll get all nice and tan. I'll be looking pretty. So I'm excited about going, if you can't tell.
Yeah. Well, you're going to be front and center every day that we're there. So we appreciate you putting so much time into us. Let's say I'm watching this video right now and I'm on the fence about, you know, whether I should make the energy effort, you know, because for some, it's going to be that they probably got to move some things around. Traveling is not the easiest thing in the world, you know, for some people right now, you know, maybe coming from Canada and other places. All right. But you and I both know that if you want to improve your personally, professionally, and financially, you know, sometimes you got to, you know, literally crawl over broken glass for a country mile to experience that. So give us some insight into the importance of sacrifice to whatever you need to do to be at a conference like this when it really is going to be transformative. Like, what's your best advice in that area?
Well, I'll start with the personal example. That week, my daughter is getting married. And so we're in the middle of all the wedding preparations, and we'll have a wedding that very week before the conference. And so I had to take a look at things. My wife had some surgery. We had to check with the doctors and make sure it's okay for her to travel, because I love for her to be there with me. And so, yeah, you're going to have to arrange some things. But, and there's also a cost factor. But here's the question that I was asked years ago by John Maxwell. He said, if you won't invest in you, who else would? If you're not willing to invest in your own personal improvement plan, and that's something that I can't tell you how much I believe in it. That's why I'm reading all the time. That's why I'm listening to podcasts all the time. That's why I'm going to conferences. That's why I'll be going down to Cancun to be with you guys, is to be able to share the things that I'm learning and staying fresh with right now, because that's the key. You got to keep that momentum going. And, you know, our brain and our entire lives, if you're not continually getting better, you're going to get worse. There's not a place where you can just call time out and go, well, you know, I'm at a spot and I'm just going to kind of stay here. The law of entropy says if you are not progressively getting better, then you're going to digress and you're going to go backward. So what better time of year to go, I'm going to give myself a treat. I'm going to go to absolutely gorgeous Cancun. We're staying at the same property that we stayed at last June, which was spectacular. We came back and told our family, we've now found a place that we want to go try as a family rather than trucking all the way to Hawaii, because it was such a beautiful place. And the hotel is just absolutely fabulous. All the great food around it. An Italian restaurant within that hotel that is world class, where they're making the pasta and showing you everything. It's just a fun, wonderful place to be. So I would see this as my reward, and I'm doing something for myself. And knowing that you can kickstart your year by getting in there at the end of February, the 1st of March, at the end of that first quarter, and going, now then, let's put it on hyperspeed the rest of this year. So that's why I wanted to move things. When you called me, I was like, heck yeah. You know, you better believe it. I'm so excited about getting to go with you guys.
There is something to say for making yourself better, you know, as a personally and of course, professionally, you know, our businesses pretty much drive every area of our life, you know, both personally, having more time to be able to do things you want, and financially, to be able to have the freedom to be able to do even more of it. So, look, I can't thank you enough for taking us up on the invitation to come down there and pour into us all that you've got there. So, again, on behalf of Craig Proctor, myself, everybody associated with, you know, this event, thank you, my man. We appreciate it.
Hey, listen, I'm excited. I'll leave you with that thought that's been driving me the last few years. The day that your memories are greater than your dreams, you're dead in the water. Yep. So let's go dream together. Let's go get excited together, because I know your home so guaranteed is going to see its biggest year ever as we go serve big with each other, buddy.
There you go. So you guys have heard it from Dr. Ike now. So if you haven't registered or RSVP'd for this event, hopefully that will motivate you to do it. And we are looking forward to working with you there. And we'll see you at 9 a.m. sharp on February 28th, right there in the conference room at the JW, right there on the shores of Cancun. So again, thanks. And Ike, appreciate it. Everyone, go serve big. We'll see you.